हेलो, वेलकम टू दी वीडियो लेक्चर क्लास नंबर 7 ऑन यूनिट नंबर 5 पावर डिवाइसेस एंड डिस्प्ले डिवाइसेस। टुडेस क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू सी फर्स्ट टॉपिक चार्ज कपल्ड डिवाइस। व्हाट इज अ चार्ज कपल्ड डिवाइस? ए सेमीकंडक्टर डिवाइस दैट इज यूज्ड एस्पेशली एज एन ऑप्टिकल सेंसर that stores charge and transfer it sequentially to an amplifier and an inductor. Here, three figures are shown. The first figure is an ultraviolet CCD image. The second sample is Argus 2.1 megapixel camera, and third one is Sony 10.1 megapixel camera. These are the sample applications of CCD, charge coupled device. A charge coupled device allows the transportation of electrical charged analog signals through different capacitors set up in a series. This device is controlled by a clock signal that oscillates between high and low rates, that is positive and zero voltage level. The entire system attached as a shift resistor has its inputs and outputs linked together in series, which allows a charge coupled device be used as a way of delaying analog signals. That is CCD internal pixels are arranged in the form of capacitors. Each pixel acts, each capacitor acts as a pixel. The pixel receives the light signal and convert into electrical signal. Those electrical signals are saved in the your memory card or the SD card. The way that a charged coupled device works in capturing images is by focusing an image and projected from a lens onto a photoactive capacitor array, that is pixel. This results in each capacitor, that is pixels, accumulating an electronic charge that is proportional to the light intensity of the image. This captures a two-dimensional image that is transferred to a charge amplifier, which in turn converts into voltage. This image is then stored digitally in a memory module. That is, here the memory module is nothing but your SD card or memory card. A basic charged coupled device is efficient in capturing luminance, but it has difficulty rendering color. To solve this problem, modern digital cameras use a device called a Bayer mask powered CCD. This the modern CCD used to capture color images. It links four pixels into blocks, two for red and blue, and last two for green color, because the human eye can identify green more readily than other colors. This figure shows how the charge coupled device work. Here the figure shows three pixels. The first three pixels, if the light impinge on the light from the image impinge on this first charge coupled device, when it is excited by a gate voltage, positive voltage, the electrons are created. Here no electrons are created for another two pixels. When a gate voltage applied to the another pixel, depending upon the applied light intensity, focused light intensity, different amount of electrons are created. Similarly, the last one, if you apply a voltage to the last pixel, depending upon the light intensity, it will produce different amount of electrons. Figure 4 shows this one. So each pixel acts as a capacitor. Depending upon the applied gate voltage and depending upon the image intensity pixels received, different amount of electrons are produced. These different amount of electrons store different amount of electrical energy in your memory card, so that automatically differentiate image portions in the memory card. What are the applications of CCD? Digital cameras, video recorders, and pictures and phones, infrared sensors, cameras also. Next one is UJT. What is UJT? Unijunction transistor. Unijunction transistor mainly used for as an oscillator or for triggering or generating shortwave triangular waveforms. Figure 1A shows the basic structure of unijunction transistor. It has two terminals, base 1 and base 2. Nearby base 2, an P-type substrate is fused. From P-type substrate, emitter terminal is taken. Figure 1B shows the circuit symbol of the unijunction transistor. The emitter is arrow mark of emitter shown near to base terminal. Since emitter is taken from the base terminal 2, so that's why the arrow mark put near to base terminal 2. Figure 1C shows the equivalent circuit of unijunction transistor. The unijunction transistor two terminals, base 2 and base 1, in between center point and base 2 you are having RB2 resistance, in between center point and base 1 you are having RB1 resistance. A bias voltage VBB applied in between base 2 and base 1, positive terminal of the bias control to the base 2, negative terminal of the bias control to the base 1, and an emitter signal or emitter voltage applied in between emitter and ground. The emitter and base 2 combination. Base 2 made up of N-type material, emitter is made up of P-type material. The combination of these two will act as will behave like as a diode that's shown in here. The figure 1D shows the input characteristics of UJT. Initially it will have some minimum voltage. Once emitter voltage is applied, positive emitter voltage is applied, the UJT starts to contact. Once it reaches the peak point, the emitter voltage starts to decreases with increasing in the emitter current up to valley point. From peak point to valley point, the current, emitter current increases whereas the emitter voltage decreases. So this is the behavior of the negative resistance regions. What may be positive resistance regions? Voltage increases, current increases. Voltage decreases, current decreases. That is the characteristics of positive resistance region. For negative resistance region, if voltage increases, here if you increase any for bias applied to the emitter terminal above the peak point, the emitter voltage in the voltmeter starts to decrease due to reduction of the electrons and holes combination. But with increasing in the emitter current, so this is the negative resistance region, and above the valley point it reaches the saturation value. Figure 2A is the circuit used to generate the relaxation oscillator. Here the relaxation oscillator, no voltage applied to the emitter terminal, only bias is applied to the UJT. The output voltage is taken across the capacitor. C is the emitter capacitor, R is the emitter resistor, and the output voltage is taken across the emitter terminal. And the voltage across the R1 is called VB1, voltage across B2 is equal to B2 terminal is the VB2. What is the output voltage across the emitter capacitor VCE? V0 equal to is in the form of sawtooth waveform like this. The voltage across VE varies from valley point voltage to peak voltage here. From valley point to peak point, the VB2 reaches maximum voltage value, and from peak point to valley point, VB2 voltage reaches minimum value. The voltage across VB1 is in the form of sawtooth waveform. From valley point to peak point, a spike will appear across base 1 terminal, and from valley point to peak point, some constant voltage appeared across base 1. In the previous figure seen, if you more bias the P PN junction diode followed by as the junction. Voltage across, if you measure the voltage across that particular device, it will automatically, if you the device more forward bias, in the sense the voltage across that devices starts to decreases. It will behave like a short circuit device. So if you measure the voltage across that particular device, you will get a minimum voltage, maximum current. That is the concept in this behind in this negative resistance region. The working principle already we discussed. What is the total base resistance? RBB equal to RB1 plus RB2. The intrinsic standoff ratio is given by RB1 divided by RB1 plus RB2. Voltage across terminal base 1 terminal V1 equal to intrinsic standoff ratio into total bias applied VBB. What is the main application of UJT? UJT act as a relaxation oscillator for generating sawtooth waveform. Why it is called as an oscillator? Without applying any AC input, by using VBB DC bias, the relaxation oscillator produces sawtooth waveform. That is why it is called as oscillator. Here we have derived the frequency of the output sawtooth waveform. What is the expression to find out the frequency of the output sawtooth waveform generated? Here this is the expression for output sawtooth waveform. The time period of the output sawtooth waveform is given by T is equal to 2.303 RECE log to the base 10 1 by 1 minus eta. Frequency is equal to 1 by time period, that is equal to this value. Diag is a diode that conducts electrical current only after its breakover voltage has been reached. Diag stands for a diode for alternating current. That is, what do you mean by, what is the difference between diag and a diode? Diode conducts for either positive half cycle or negative half cycle, whereas diode conducts for both positive half cycle, for positive half of the input AC cycle and negative half of the input AC cycle. So diag is different from diode. Diode conducts for either positive half cycle or negative half cycle. Diag conducts for both positive half cycle and negative half cycle. A diag is a device which has two electrodes and it is a member of thyristor family. Diags are used in the triggering of thyristors. This is a sample of diag we used in our lab. This one is the basic structure of diag, PNPN and PNPN. This one terminal 2, this one terminal 1, that is empty. One is the anode 1 and empty 2 is anode 2. No cathodes are available outside. This is the symbol of diag. We can use this symbol, either this symbol or this symbol for diag. Now we are going to explain the construction details of diag. Note that neither terminal is referred to as the cathode. Already we discussed, only we are having anode terminals only. No cathodes are available outside the diag. Instead, there is an anode 1 or electrode 1 or empty 1 and anode 2 or electrode 2 empty 2. When anode 1 is positive, this one is positive with respect to this anode 2. That is, if it is the anode 1 positive and this one negative, then semiconductor layers of particular interest are P1, N2, P2, N3. For if anode 2 is positive and anode 1 is negative, the semiconductor layer semiconductor layers of particular interest are P2, N2, P1, N1. Diag VI characteristics. Yes, the voltage is increased from 0. So we are having output for both forward bias and reverse bias. Quadrant 1, this one is the quadrant 1, this one is the quadrant 3. Quadrant 1, both voltage and current both are positive. Quadrant 2, voltage and current both are quadrant 3, both voltage and current are negative. So we are having output for positive half cycle and negative half cycle. We are having the output for both the positive half cycle and the negative half cycle. As the voltage is increased from zero either direction, a small amount of leakage current occurs. This one is the leakage current, as shown in the Fick-Karsik curve. when BBO is reached in either direction, either forward bias or reverse bias, then a negative difference difference resistance region similar to that of UJT is observed. This one. After the breakover voltage is reached, this point, the tire contacts current easily and has a very little internal resistance. Conduct state for positive half cycle. Conduct state for negative half cycle. The diode looks like a semiconductor diode. It is not coated for polarity. That is, it has only anode terminals. No cathode terminals. Because it acts the same in both directions. What are the applications of diode? Diodes, because of their symmetrical bidirectional switching characteristics, are widely used as a triggering device in track phase control circuits, employing for lamp dimmer, heat control, inversion motor, speed control. That's all about class number 7, unit number 5, power devices and display devices. We will see the remaining topics on next class, class number 8. Thank you. Good evening.